Джуфна Шавага. Шава топ. I'd like to first extend blessing to the Shemesh family, Shlomo Rachel. It's a beautiful event. And a big thanks to all of you for in this kind of weather. You came together from all over, and we're very proud of you. And this act of unity should bring a lot of Kedusha Be'ezrat Hashem. Shekulam Biyachad. In our parasha, I'm going to start with you a very difficult question or issue, and hopefully we can learn something tonight which will give us insight about our life. One of the biggest questions that we have, that Moshe Rabbeinu worked so much, but he never went to Israel. Where is Canaan? And we try to find why, but the main question is, why not? He wanted so much, so why not? But in order to build it, I would like to start with in the parasha when Moshe Rabbeinu is telling to Hashem, I don't want to go. And a few times he rejects. And the last time he says, Shlachna biyat ishlach. Please let Aaron run the show. Rashi on Shlachna biyat ishlach, he says the following. Biyat ishlach, send, you appointed Aaron to be the leader of Am Israel in Mitzrayim. Davar acher, in a different person you're going to shloach, she'ein sofi le'achnisam le'eretz Yisrael v'liot v'olam la'atid.
Who yada mi'az?
I'm asking. This is my question. Again, Rashi says, explaining in English, find the person that you will choose to bring them inside the land of Israel. She'ein sofi le'achnisam la'eretz. Great writes in Rashi, clear, that Moshe Rabbeinu, at the beginning of the beginning, is telling to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, I will not be the one who will finish this mission. This is the third Rashi. We go a few pages to the end of the parasha, and over here there is another Rashi. Now the question is like this, what is the scenario? Moshe is coming and he's promising and the people say, yes, I'm Israel, we wait. And then Moshe goes back to out of the state. And for many months they're alone and Paro becomes so insecure and he gives so many problems to them. So when Moshe came after a few months, Am Israel told him, Moshe, with all the respect, why didn't stay in your father-in-law? Since you came, you promised, but nothing happened. How do you say, Mukharen, Batarshu, Beitarnashu? And Moshe came and asked Hashem, Hashem said, why? For what? Why it's needed? Lama, lama? Hashem is answering Moshe, Ata tireh. Now we are going to see what I'm going to do to Pharaoh. Rashi. מה זה אתה תראה? You had questions about my actions. When I told to Abraham, sacrifice your son,
no questions.
When I asked, לפיכך אתה תראה, you are going to see the miracles of Paro, ולא תראה את המלכי שבע אומות שאביהם לארץ. You will not see the miracles inside of the land of Israel. So what do you learn from here?
That he's not going on Israel.
When?
Before even they came out.
No. At the beginning we say, when Hashem asked him to go. Now we see from this Rashi over here, He came to Egypt, he started to walk. Nothing happened yet. But Hashem is telling him, Ata tir'e now, but not later. Lost case. This was the Rashi said. Ikach sifte chachamim, he asked a question. It says in Parashat Ve'alotcha, after, for a long time after they left Egypt, it says that Moshe is asking his father-in-law to come with them, with Yitro. And Moshe is telling to Yitro, Nos'im anachnu el hamakom, asher diber, asher amor oto asher eten lachem. Come with us. Omer Rashi, Nos'im anu el hamakom, in 3 days we coming to you go inside Eretz Israel. And it says over here, Anachnu nichnasim la'aretz. Mi ze anachnu?
All of us.
All of us. What does it mean? Moshe Rabbeinu is sure what?
Shuken
nichnas. You see over here?
Ken.
Azomer, Omer Rashi over here, but Moshe Rabbeinu was promised not to go. As Omer Rashi, Adain lo nigzera gzera, there was not a decree, so he was sure that he is going inside. Omer Siftei Chachamim, he said, but you say over here, he's not going. What Hashem is telling him? Ata tire? No, Ata tire, you're not going there.
You see this, but not later.
Yes. But what, over here he says, no gzera, but he says, that tire.
Yeah.
As Omer, in Kisei Verchamim, maybe I understand it that one explanation that I'm going to go inside Eretz Israel and then die before the war. One explanation. Second explanation, I'm going to come like a tourist, not like a general. Mo pensia, retired. Very difficult explanation. Moshe Rabbeinu will come like retiree to Israel. But this is what he explains. But still, I have a question to ask you. According to what Rashi says, Ata tireh, now you are going to see the miracles and not later the miracles, means there is no Eretz Israel. Okay. Now, we continue. And Moshe Rabbeinu, in Sefer Dvarim, he talks about the history of Am Yisrael. And listen what he says. He says, we came out of Egypt. You got the Ten Commandments. We built the Mishkan. And we were ready to go to Eretz Israel. And you came and asked me, before we go in, we need to appoint a group of spies to spy the land of Israel. Remember the story?
Yes.
Good. And they went to Israel and they came. And then he said over here, Moshe, Vayitav be'enai adavar. I like the idea. Omer Rashi, I like it, but not Hashem. Omer Rashi said, if Moshe liked it, why complain now? If you liked it, why are you complaining? Umeri, I tried to tell them, I'm so sure, you have to trust me, they will trust me. So it went back to them. Hai guftan, there. And then Moshe say, you came and you messed up big time. And then Moshe Rabbeinu, he says, Gam bit anaf Hashem, Hashem became very upset about me and told me, you don't go there. Where? When it happened, after 1 year, then they left Egypt. Kakatuv, Gam bit anaf Hashem, biglalchem lemor gam ata lo tavo sham. What does it mean in English? Okay, kan nia 100%. Yofi. Omer, aya 100, sham nia 200, according to Boris. So where's the 200% now? Tell us about Shem. We continue. 38 years left afterwards. 38 years. And it says, after 38 years, no water. Miriam died, no water. So Hashem turned to Moshe, talk to the rock, and Moshe hit the rock. And then he says over here, Vayomer Hashem el Moshe, the Torah says, and to Aharon, because you didn't do the right action over here, lo tavou et aviu et hakahal hazeh la'aretz. You stay in the desert. According to Boris, 300%.
No, yes,
Upgrade now. There is gzera with an oath. Seder? Okay. So, first time Moshe got the mission, he said, I will not go. Second time, when he said, why Hashem you made everything so wrong, didn't come. Number three, in the Meraglim, you don't go. Number four, but over here there is upgrade. It's already with an oath, Shvua. And it continues. Then afterwards, we are coming close to Edom. Today is Jordan. And they don't want to help us, we left them. Then we came to Hor HaHar when Aaron passed away. Then we went to Sichon. And we won them. Seder? So now, another time passed. Few months. Sichon ve'og, then in Tzayim Ayom, Yarden. Jordan. And then, Moshe Rabbeinu, Parashat Vayetchanan, כמו שאמר beautifully Boris, he says over here, Vayetchanan el Hashem ba'et ha'il lemor. And in this time I pray to Hashem. מה זה בעת ההיא? אומר רש"י, after the war of Sichon ve'Og. So he was told, you don't go, there is a swear, there is this. ויתחנן. אז עכשיו, אז הוא אומר, מה זה ויתחנן הזה? He says over here, Moshe Rabbeinu start to pray. אף על פי שנגזרה גזרה. There is a גזרה. There is a decree. There is שבועה. אמר לו, ממך למדתי, שאמר ואתה אני חלי. אלא לפתוח פה שבי היה טוב להתפלל עליהם וכו'. אומר רש"י, משה רבנו תות, the gzera is over. Based on what? I want to ask you, when was the gzera? When משה רבנו knew he doesn't go to Israel?
Before
he went to
Midian.
What?
In Midian, when Hashem came to him.
The first time you see.
First time.
Very optimistic. So why he's praying and saying, Rabbeinu Shalom, you know, checking the Boshan Amidlo.
When
you
Breslev,
huh? Oh! Eddie Yofi, Israel Amir, you lamad, you limit the Tarav in Breslev. No Yush. Never give up. I like it. So, continue. He says in Masechet Shabbat, Daf Pei Zayin 87, three things Moshe Rabbeinu made from his own understanding. נכון?
כן.
שלושה דברים, משה יוסיף מדעתו. מה הקדוש ברוך הוא אמר לו?
חזק.
Very good. נכון?
כן.
I want to ask you, how can God tell to Moshe Rabbeinu, you did what you wanted, and I agree to it? Moshe Rabbeinu is a messenger. Seder? Does a messenger have the right to make decisions?
No.
There is a halacha in Shulchan Aruch. Let's say you ask your messenger to go to buy you 1 kilogram of silver. You went to the market and you bought 1 kilogram of gold. So you say, I didn't buy it, I asked you to buy it. I said, no, but you're my, I thought it's a better price, so I bought for you. What do you tell him?
Well,
you are my messenger.
Wrong connection.
But over here, Moshe Rabbeinu has the right to do what Shlomo? He's doing, he's adding stuff. Instead of 2 days, 3 days.
But when you bring Tumah, when you have a messenger, you're making to give Tumah, and you can give it.
But
you ask him. He says you get from the good one, and if there really is a good one, there is means you meant it, so it means you can make a decision.
No. At the moment that the messenger walks on his mind, the mission is nullified.
He went and gave to him,
שליח שעשה שליח, שולה עשה שליח אותו לפי מה שהוא רוצה, מה תגיד לו?
That's what happens to our son, no?
Who?
Aaron's son.
They did whatever they wanted and punished, no? Because you're not allowed to do. Over here, Moshe Rabbeinu has a certain. So ask the question.
This is more than son.
What?
The message of
love. What?
The level of the Mechutan, because it's a higher level.
ישמח משה במתנה, even in Mesut we say, כי עבד נאמן קראת לו.
נכון, אבל לא בכל, תלוי באיזה פרק.
He's a messenger. Our messenger can change.
This parasha talks about asking Hashem's name.
No.
So he was asking from Hashem to get permission to do whatever he wants.
Ask whatever you want. But do what I ask you to do.
Which means he's more than messenger.
Oh. Moshe Rabbeinu was in heaven. And he saw something interesting in heaven. He saw in heaven that all the Gan Eden, all the Gzerot, all the plants, all everything is totally in your hand. Human beings are responsible for 100%. He says, "Mimoshe leMoshe, lo kam kemoshe." The Maimonides, I read you Ilchot Tshuva, the fifth chapter, the beginning. Reshut lechol adam liyot netuna liyot tzadik or rasha. What does it mean?
A person
has a freedom of choice to decide if he wants to be tzadik or rasha. Who chooses it?
Person himself.
Himself. Not his wife, not her husband, not the children, not the grandparents. Not the Russian education, not the Communist Party, nothing. His choice. Now, Alachar Bet. Al Yavo b'machshavtecha. Even don't dare to think that what? Davar ze omrim tipshei umot ha'olam ve'golmei bnei Yisrael. Don't even dare to think what the people who are not smart, Gentiles or Jews, שהקדוש ברוך הוא גוזר על האדם מתחילת בריאתו. שהקדוש ברוך הוא has a destiny, a person, predestined, that a person is going what Hashem is running to him. אין הדבר כן. And now see what he says. אלא כל אדם ראוי להיות כמשה רבנו, איש אופס, כלבי משה רבנו, או שרה אמנו, או כירובן בן נבט, דיבל, דבר נושא פרידם, רבותיי, הלכה ברמב"ם. It's not philosophy, זה הלכה. The הלכה says the following. The people who didn't come tonight to the shiur didn't want to come to the shiur. Rabbi, it's called for you too, you can. Rabbi, Shalom Bayit can be over here too. I'm tired. הכל טוב יפה. The bottom line, Roma, כתוב חציות פרישו. Whoever wanted came. Now, how to make it nice, it's other thing. דסם, פוצ'ים, סרם, דין, בבור, ביבים, this is already, it's already, it's it. אומר הרמב״ם, משה רבנו was in heaven, and הרמב״ם went to הלכה, there is no way in life that people will not be responsible for their actions. And each of us can be משה רבנו, and can be רבן בן נבט, can be שרה אמנו, can be זבל, it's totally in your decision. In heaven, our life is like a blank page. You write what you want to do. It's come to a point that Moshe Rabbeinu is breaking the two tablets. What Hashem is telling him? Good. What's so good in this? You did something and you really felt the anger of Hashem inside of you. It was pure. I tested you. Good. We say in Masechet Shabbat, on Yom Shishi, when you say Kiddush, you become a partner to HaKadosh Baruch Hu in this world. Not a messenger. Nasa Shutaf Lemaaseh Bereshit. Moshe Rabbeinu was in heaven, and Moshe Rabbeinu really understand that everything in life is in our hand. We make all the decisions, we make whatever we want to do, and it's 100% belong to us. And you have access to everything if you really want to. But what's our problem, our life? One of the problems, we don't like to make decisions. Rabbi, I want to be religious, but not all the way. Rabbi, I want to do this, but not all the way. Good. But if you really want to do something, sick people, when something they really want, they know what they want to do. So I understand from Moshe Rabbeinu, from the first time he knows he doesn't go there. But what he said, Moshe Rabbeinu, it's meaningless. Why is it meaningless? Because if I really want, I'm going to go there. Prove me from the Midrashim. Hashem is telling to Moshe, Rav lach, chvat it. What Hashem is telling to Moshe? After 515 prayers, next prayers, you're going in. But there are going to be consequences. Remember? What Moshe Rabbeinu said? I give up. So, 40 years Moshe Rabbeinu knows that there is a decree not to go to Eretz Israel, but for him, he knows that it can be changed on a daily basis. Gzera, Shvua, Eswer, Kol, everything is changeable as long as you are alive. Therefore, you have to love life as a thing to change.
So when
do
you know it's enough to push?
Huh?
You know what, it's not
the after you start, usually. One of my students on Rosh Hashanah, now in America, Baruch Hashem, on the New Year, they take commitments on themselves, keep smoking and this. He decided he's going to make 10 minutes every morning sport. He came walk sun. January 1st was a very cold day for him. So he said, I'll start with my finger. It's good. physical surah. Tosher Rabotu. You know, when you really want something, you'll do it. If I were Moshe, I would go in. You want to go? Go.
So why did he stop?
Ask him. I missed like his motion. In the concept, but this is what his decision. Remember, no decree, no shua, no nothing. On can take as on some rishil. Put spanya shon chotch, no on rishil. This is the question I'm telling you. If you make a decision, and you really made a decision, you're going to make it happen. This is our problem. We don't know what we want. It's another problem, but this is, we need 10 sessions with a professional psychologist.
Because he didn't believe in himself.
What?
Because he didn't believe that he's going to be in there.
Talk about ourselves now for 1 second. How many decisions we make because we don't want to make decisions? Yeah, Gamu should do it. I tell you I was in a place and it was somebody who was over there. He couldn't speak English, so I was translating. So he had heart attack. So they came and put him a mask on his face. So I had to translate. So he asked me, how old is he? Do you want to give him? So I asked him, how old are you? So he told me, by in documents or the real one? I told him, oh, the Rav Sadi, he goes, you're about to die after 2 minutes. Yeah, chugam. He has a mask on his face, oxygen, problem with the heart, chugam. Say, how are you? How old are you? What's the big deal? Malka, we are so messed up with ourselves. And then we start to lie to ourselves. And we start to tell to ourselves all kind of stories. Moshe Rabbeinu is telling us, from the first day Hashem told him go, he said, I'm not going to go to Israel. But it doesn't mean anything. If I want to go, I'll go. And he's right. Hashem told him after 1:15, pray, the same Moshe Rabbeinu, another prayer, you're going in. Now make decision. Moshe said, I don't go because I love Am Israel. Excellent. But it was his decision, not the same decision. You told me there was over here, Lo Tikanes, Ken Tikanes, went first time, second time, third time, four times, Shvot, Ezeh. It doesn't mean anything. What do you want? And everything is changeable. Everything. As long as you are alive, you can change. What do we like to say? In Bukharan we say, Tachdira, Sudba, predestined, Chokunim. Yes, Gabriel.
Basically, Al Yadut, from the time from Matan Torah, it's built by the guard not to know this kind of stuff. If you go through the soul, you can reveal this type of information. But our, it's like a frame, not to go to this idea. So the nation, the Jewish nation, there is a kind of confusion about this kind of statements. It's true, I agree with this, but our Judaism doesn't build this way. So how to come out from this misgiving?
Gabriel,
eventually this
how many times you heard, Baruch Hashem, you went to many shiurim in your life, that Am Yisrael is going to be built with Ahavat Chinam. How many times you heard? At least 500,000 times. Did it help us? We say, don't put the hatred aside and put the jealousy aside and just be in love with your friend like you love yourself.
But to know
every rabbi is saying
it. To know is not enough, Rabbi.
Huh?
To know there's a system that not right to this direction, Rabbi. It's not
the bottom line, Gabriel, we have to stand to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and tell him, what do you want?
Everything has to be changed for that purpose. Everything, no. Everything, the system that we live, the Judaism have to be
no,
changed.
No, no, you're going the wrong direction. I'm asking a question. Yes. What do you want? Roma, what do you want?
I'm not strong enough to make a decision according to my living life
in
Judaism.
Oh, you're not strong.
No, it's not. I'm talking about based on Am Yisrael Quran.
I have a student, he has to come tomorrow to pray 7 o'clock. He said, Rabbi, it's too early. But he has to go to work 5 o'clock, go 5 o'clock to work. Why? I told him, but why to go to work 5 o'clock? He said, Rabbi, because I have to go. Here, I don't have to go.
So
his decision is not cold, it's not late, it's not early. In his computer, he put a wrong decision. And he said, Rabbi, to work, I have to work, but to come to shul, if I'm хорошее настроение, там хорошая погода, and you woke me up like the head of the rabbi, then I come. But now I don't want to come. No, I cannot come. He's lying to himself. Because he's not lying. He made a decision. Don't run away from the personal liability of our decisions. You ask him, so what do you want?
I don't think people believe in that they have much choice about that.
It's even easy.
That you cook yourself, it's like a robotic system.
Nobody talks about Shulchan Aruch. We talk about over here your choices.
But this is more open information for that.
Shulchan Aruch will tell you from which store to buy which meat. It's not the question. But the question of you,
right.
Will you start a diet once in your life? Lose 50 pounds, 20 pounds. Not for where to buy meat. For where not to buy. Or when you see and you get excited, you say, Hi, it's after the Shinaim diet. So what do you really want? Every time they send junk mail, take this medication, you're going to lose weight without losing eating. You have to eat, you're going to lose. People looking for magic remedies for nothing. Doesn't exist. You want to lose weight, lose weight. You know how to do it. Hi, say Gamish of that. This is Moshe Rabbeinu is teaching us. So my question to you, when was the Gzera of going to Eretz Israel?
The very beginning.
No. Moshe Rabbeinu knew that the last decision...
Gzera Zaya Basov.
No.
Zaya Basov. According to Masha Asha Adunamadun Zaya Basov. His decision Shalom.
I didn't understand what I'm saying. Boris, Hashem is telling him after 515 prayers, Moshe, another prayer, you're going in. What does it mean?
Continue.
What does it
mean?
אין גזרה. אבל למה שאין גזרה?
כי הוא לקח על עצמו, אבל אין גזרה.
למה אין גזרה? יש כתוב כאן, פה כתוב, שם כתוב, כתוב.
לא משנה מה כתוב.
מה כתוב? לא משנה מה כתוב?
בחירה
אצלו. בחירה, you still have the choice.
המפתחות אצלו.
או יבדה קיז.
הוא נתן את המפתח, הוא אמר, טוב, אני לא משתמש בו.
100%.
אז רבי עקיבא, אתה יודע,
there is a joke, somebody, after people died, they took their brain to sell. So Einstein's brain was sold for 10,000 and regular person 100,000. So say, this is brand new, this is used. So he died without using his brain. And it's still in the parcel box, you know. So as a brand, as a disposal, they're not used, they sell it like a...
According to this, what should people do with that?
Rabbi Akiva accepted this. Rabbi Akiva say, I wish all my life and I pray that I want to die. So we died like this.
Well,
it says that one of the rabbis was screaming. Hashem told him, another scream, I'm going to destroy the world, I won't touch you. Very simple. You are responsible for your action. Don't look for people to blame. If you are not a good husband, don't blame your wife. If you're not a good wife, don't blame your husband. Just bear consequences. Talk about yourself. So what do you want? One of my students has insecurity issues. He drives his wife crazy. When she goes, okay, say, Rabbi, you see? And the woman didn't. He didn't do what I did. I said, but you make her crazy. It's only worries and worries and worries. Women like to worry and put worries on her. They say, see? I called the woman to shoot her. I say, you make it crazy with your insecurities. Really, no, Rabbi, you don't know her. I say, I know you. Why doesn't it take Bukhla Jangrik, Jangrik, and so good? My grandmother used to say in some account, people used to break the walls. But so there was a lot of dust who damaged the lin, the laundry of other people. In the, they say, we answer for the wall, not for the dust. But you did it. I think so. I was thinking, what somebody say about over here, over here? It comes to a bottom line. No gzerot. You make everything. Everything is in your hand, and you can be Moshe Rabbeinu. You ask me, I can hardly read. Rabbi Akiva, Rabbi Akiva, Roma, listen. Rabbi Akiva, when he was 40 years old, he didn't know how to read Alf, he didn't know how to read Hebrew. When he became 80 years old, it says that Moshe Rabbeinu saw him in a vision. And Moshe Rabbeinu is telling to Hashem, why you give the Torah to me, not through him. Until 40 years old, he was member of the Communist Party. He hated religion. He said, if I'm going to see any Talmid Chacham, I'm going to bite him like a donkey. And then he started to work on himself. At the age of 80, he becomes so educated, Moshe Rabbeinu is telling to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he's better candidate than me. So you tell me, how can you do it like this? Because he really wanted. This what all this, the Shlach Be'at Shlach, Hashem is telling to Moshe, oh, what do you want?